Hello everyone, welcome to the third tutorial of Excel automation using Blue Prism. My name is Ritansh and today I'll teach you how you can perform filter functionality in Excel using Blue Prism. As we all know that we don't have any inbuilt feature to perform filter in Excel, and many of us prefer taking data into collection and then perform filter in collection. Though that is also an approach to perform filter, but taking all the data in collection means you are taking everything in Blue Prism memory, which basically is not a good approach, and you'll start facing issues when your bot goes live in production, and also collection has a limit. So if we are dealing with lakhs and lakhs of records, we will not be able to perform the filter functionality in collection. Ultimately, it will gonna break the memory of Blue Prism and your bot can crash. So rather than using collection to perform filter, why shouldn't we use filter in Excel only? So today I'll show you how you can use the code stage to write the code for applying filter in Excel and perform your tasks. So before applying filter in Excel using Blue Prism, let's see how we can apply filter in Excel manually. So below are the scripts which we generally follow to apply a filter. So suppose we have a sample data. As you can see, this is a sample data worksheet in which we have certain set of records. And now, if you want to apply a filter on this particular sheet, then how we will perform it manually? So for performing that, we'll go to data section, click on filter. Suppose I want all the data of East region. In that case, I'll go column B, select only East, and this is my filtered data. Okay. And now, if you want to perform the exact same functionality using Blue Prism, obviously you will be taking all the data into collection and then perform the task, which I said will not be a good approach in case if you have lots and lots of data. So I'll teach you how we can perform the same steps using Blue Prism. So let me close this worksheet. I have created a sample process in which I'm just creating an instance of Excel, opening that particular workbook which I showed you, showing it and maximizing it. Okay, let me just copy this action stage. I'll give the name apply filter. And we know that there is no as such inbuilt functionality, right? And now we don't have the code for that. So what I'll do, I'll go to this action by right clicking on it and then view action in Object Studio. I'll go to the starting point and here I'll create a new page called apply filter. Now we require this code stage to perform our task. So I have already copied the code. So let me just copy paste it, apply filter. So I already have the code copied. So I'm just copy pasting it. So now let's try to understand this code, what this code is trying to say. It is simply saying that we have to apply filter on the active sheet based on our conditions. So first we have to identify what is our active sheet, and in order to identify active sheet, we have to define a variable called worksheet. So we have done the same way. We have just defined a variable called worksheet. Dim simply means in VB.NET panel, we have to define a variable. We use dim, and this is a data type. So it simply means that worksheet is a variable of type object, and on this worksheet we have to first identify what is the active worksheet. So using get workbook, we are just fetching the workbook name, and then dot active worksheet, it will give me the active worksheet name into this variable. Once we get this active worksheet name, we can easily apply the filter using auto filter functionality. So what we are doing in this line, worksheet.useRange, that means whatever data we have selected will just apply the auto filter on it, and these are the two inputs, field to be filtered and criteria. So this criteria will be our criteria to apply the filter, and this field means the column number, on which column number we are trying to apply the filter. So let's pass these two variables as an input. So I'm just copying it. Let me pass. So here if you see, there are three variables which will be passed as an input. First is handle, second is field to be filtered, and the third one is criteria to filter. So I'll just pass handle, data type number. Second is field to be filtered. This is of number type. And criteria to filter, since this is a criteria, actual criteria, so it will be of text type. Now let me take three data items. One is handle, second is field to be filtered, number, and third one is criteria. it is of type text, and we will be passing these three parameters from the start. So these will be the starter parameters. So this is a handle, this is a field, and this is the criteria. So I'll be mentioning handle. So I can just join it now and publish this particular action. So now let me add those variables in the input. So this is a filter criteria, this is a field to filter, and this is the handle. Now let me save it. Apply filter, code added. Now if I just close it and if I just reset my process, I should be able to see this particular action, apply filter. Now since I have to apply the filter on the second column, if I just show it to you, so this is a column in which I need to apply the filter, and A represents 1, B represents 2, C represents 3, like this. Okay, and we have to apply the filter on column B. So that means I'll be using field to be filtered as 2 and filter criteria. In my case, I require only the east regions. Okay, so I'll be using the expression as double quotes equal to east, that's it. Okay, so if I just evaluate this expression, it will be equal to east. So let me just click on OK and let me just run the bot after resetting it. And you can see that the filter has been applied. Okay, similarly, if I want to apply the filter on the item field, okay, and I just need pencil. So what I'll be doing, I'll be just going to apply filter. So what is the column name? D. So that means it will be 4, and I require pencil. So instead of east, I'll be writing pencil. Click on OK. Let me reset it and let me run it again. And you can see that the bot has applied the filter on item column. So this is how you're performing the filter in MS Excel. Thank you guys for watching this video. If you want to see more of my videos, please subscribe my channel and provide your feedback in the comments. Thank you. Thank you everyone. Bye bye.